दिल है छोटा सा, छोटी सी आशा, मस्ती भरे मन के, भोली सी आशा।
Hi guys, this is Jason here from Nathaniel, and let's learn Dil Hai Chota Sa, a great song by A.R. Rahman himself. So the entire song is pretty much on D major scale. So it's important when you're figuring out the chords to first understand what are the available chords. Then anything you're going to play in the song is just going to be like a mashup or a jumbling of those chords. So D major, let's just go through the scale and the chords once. D major has seven notes, as most scales have. Two sharps, right? F sharp and C sharp. And the available chords are D major, which is the one major, G major, which is the four major, A major, which is the five major, then E minor, which is the two minor, F sharp minor, which is the three minor, and B minor, which is our sixth minor. And then you also have a diminished chord, which is C sharp diminished, which is rarely used in, at least in pop songs. You may not find it that useful or that much commonly used, because it has a very evil kind of sound. Okay, so the song pretty much has about three parts. Then there are some interludes, and there's a chanting part which is sung at sort of the ending of the song. So basically, if you can just have a look at the chart, I would advise you to maybe download this chord sheet while we are learning. So then, as we are playing the song together, we can also figure out and point out which chords are happening where. And anything marked in the blue color indicates the vocal parts, and anything marked in the other color, I'm a little color blind, but whatever this color is the non-vocal parts. Okay, so just keep that in mind. So let's first start with the intro of the song, and the intro of the song is going to set in motion a nice rhythm which you could follow on the piano or any instrument. Now, the pattern which is adopted in this song is a very simple reggae pattern. Okay, reggae is very popularized, as we all know, by Bob Marley himself, and I'm sure his music or that sort of idea of playing reggae has grown to the entire planet. So let's look at the popular reggae rhythm first, and then try to apply it for all these chords of the song. So the rhythm is, I'm going to show you the rhythm on the D major chord. So it's an eighth note rhythm. So you count one and two and three and four and. So every and is going to be played on the piano right hand or on the guitar. Cha, 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 four and two and three and. So every, even on the guitar, you could look at an upstroke to play the chord. Da, na, 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 right? Three, one and two and three. And to add some color in the left hand, you could do one and two and three and. So your left hand can hit at every one and three. Let me count that again together. One and two and three and four and. One and two and three and four and. And just for additional flavor, you can even add the fifth of the chord at the three. So you could do one and two, three and four and. So basically, one and three of the left hand playing the root pretty much, or the root with another note like the fifth, and the right hand basically plays at every half beat or every and beat. So if you divide the beat by two, we say one and two and. So every and comes here, and that is pretty much the principle of reggae music. Generally, reggae will stress on the upbeats. So if you listen to a lot of, I would suggest, yeah, apart from this awesome song, of course, try to also listen to a lot of Bob Marley songs just to get the vibe of the rhythm, right? Any composer who makes a song is obviously inspired by other songs as well. So I guess a good starting point would be reggae music of Bob Marley. Okay, we'll put some links in the description of some songs you guys should definitely check out. Okay, so let's get to the main singing hook part. So let's just see how that sounds. And the chord changes happen in a slightly interesting and unique way. So let's do it once together and then we'll try and break it down, slow it down and whatnot. Okay? One, two. So again, remember the rhythm will not change for the whole song. So the rhythm I'm playing is that consistent reggae groove. It may change maybe only at that last chanting part, which A.R. Rahman sings. Okay. Okay, let's do the verse. A one, two, start.
Dil hai chota sa, choti si aasha, masti bhare man ke,
A.
bholi si aasha, chand taro ko, chune ki aasha.
Right, so let's break that down. So you have na 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 D, A na 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 D, stay on D, na 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 D, A na 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 D, D sus, sorry, D dominant 7th. That's a cool chord, let's figure that out. So if you observe, you have D played for two beats, ta na na na, 1, 2, A, 4. D, 2, 3, 4, D, 2, A, 4, D, 2, D sus, sorry, D 7th. So let's see how to form all these chords first. This is D major, A, D, F sharp. I'm just choosing this inversion because that's what I'm hearing in the song. And then, that's D. That's D again, D, A, D, this is D 7th. So basically you add the C to the same mixture. So already you have D major, which is A, D, F sharp, and you're adding the C. Okay, let's do this once more with Nupur and hear it with the singing. Two, little slower.
Dil hai chota sa,
A,
choti si aasha.
D7th. Okay, so now the chords change. Na 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 na, which is G.
G. Na 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 na, A minor, D major.
So A minor is a very interesting chord because it's not really part of the D major scale. You'd normally have A major, right? But I've circled it just to show you that, yeah, you can be a little bit creative as well. You don't have to play chords of that scale. These are what we call as borrowed chords. Okay, so let's look at that part again, or the pre-chorus. Na 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 G, na 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 A minor, D major, na 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 G, A major, na 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 D. Okay, let's look at the ending. There's a quick A and a quick D, right? Na 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 G, na 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 A minor, D major, na na G, A, na 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 D, A, D. So the last two chords are played quite fast. Na 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 na, da na 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 na, and it repeats. Na 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 na. Na, and you stay on D there, D is long. Na 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 na. D. D. A. D. D 7th. Na 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 G. Na na na. A minor. D. Na 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 G. A. Na 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 D. Dun, da, 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 da. And when you repeat it, you first repeat the whole thing once, as I've written there. And after that, you just repeat the first line once. And then you move into the other parts, like the interlude, the flute solo is there. Then there's a bunch of things in this song. There's a lot of instrumental bits as well, which are quite nice as well. Okay, so let's do this whole thing once more, the whole section, the verse, pre-chorus, this whole drill. And then I think the whole song is like, I would say 60 to 70% done. Okay, come on. One, two, go.
Dil hai chota sa,
A,
choti si aasha,
D, A. D seventh.
चांद तारों G.
A minor. D major.
G.
A.
उड़ने की
D.
आशा.
A D. Okay, A D. That thing at the end has to happen. Okay. So then what happens? Then it goes to all your interludes and all that. Before we do it, let's just look at the beginning of the song, which has this nice flute interlude as well. So let's try to do that before we move into verse 2. So you go... So that... Then the singing part comes. So let's look at those chords. That's D, 2, 3, 4. This is a very cool chord. He's playing E minor 7th here. So that's B, D, E, G. Okay. So if you don't know how to form it, it's okay. Just play this way, which I'm playing now. It'll be easy for you. So this D major, A, D, F sharp. This is E minor 7. 4-note chord, and the left hand you don't have to bother, just stick with D. That's why I wrote E minor 7th slash D. That means the left hand or the bass guitar or the bass stays the same. So you do, and the fourth beat you need to do A major. So it's 3 rounds of this chord and then 1 round of the A. So D. So D na 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 3 4. So at the 4 you play A major. Let's do that again. So now if you do the flute intro, if you want to play it on the keyboard, well, the notes are written down there. And then goes to that other part, right? So the flute tune again. A, G, F sharp, G, A, cha-da-da. And then... So it's almost the same each line, right? Okay, and now let's do the verse 2. The singing verse 2. However, there's like a interesting flute interlude which happens all through, right? So I've written down the chords there. In our lesson, we are going to mainly focus on the vocal parts, but please note that the other chords are also available for the other sections which you could download. So let me just quickly do that in fast forward. So so then it goes to that other verse 2, right? So let's look at the chords. That's the flute bit. That's E minor, A major. E minor to the A major. A sus 4. Going to the next verse. Okay, so let's do the verse 2 together with the vocals and let's see how we can figure out the chords. A 1, 2, verse 2.
Mehak jaun main aaj to aise phool bagiya mein mehke hai jaise.
Okay, let's break that down. Quite easy, right? D major na 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 na, E minor na 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 na, D major na 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 na, E minor na 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 na. Okay, so just note that E minor to A major happens very fast. So na 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 na, na 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 E minor D na 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 E minor da na 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 and now let's do the next part na 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 okay let's do the whole thing 2 3 go
mehak jaau main
E minor
aaj to aise
D again
phool bagiya mein
E minor
mehke hai jaise
and now the next part D
baadlon ki mein odo chale
A, D,
G,
G,
A,
D, G, A,
D,
and it continues, right? So let's break that down. Na na na, D, E, G, na 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 na, A, D, na 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 na, G, G. Na 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 G A na 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 D stop on A. So I've written that part down here. Na 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 A D G na 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 A D da 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 G A na 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 D and stop. You stop on that A chord. So D A dun, da, 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 dun, and goes back to the hook. So I think that's pretty much the two vocal parts. And then we go to like a nice chant part at the end. I'll just tell you a little bit about the chords before we do it with the vocals. That's that. That part. So if you see the chords which are written down here, every chord seems to have a D bass, which is the root or the sa of the song. So basically you keep that D bass and then play a toggle between the 1, which is D major, then the 4, which is the G major, and the 5, which is the A major. So you have all these interesting sounds. So it's like G major like you've never heard before, because it's G major with the D in the bottom, or A major. Normally we play A major with A, but here he's playing A major with D, which is quite interesting, right? So let's do it with the vocals and then we'll try and break it down. 1 2 3 go. G back to D, G with D bass, another instrumental part. So that's and then G with D bass, back to D bass, G with D bass, then na 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 A. So that's D quickly changing to A and then G. Remember, all these chords in the chanting part all have D in the bass. Okay, so just remember to download the chord chart so that you can follow it while we are doing it, and perhaps pause the lesson if you want to get used to each section, because this song clearly has a lot of sections, right? So we've done the main hook or the verse 1, then the verse 2, which happens after that flute bit, then the intro. But what keeps everything in common is sort of that reggae rhythm. That pretty much is the rhythm pattern for the whole song. So have fun playing this song and jam it with your friends, and yeah, have fun. Cheers.